It's an important one in an economic sense, but also coming within a year from the next federal election, we probably will see another budget before Australians go to the polls anyway, Kerry.
Yeah, I heard the Treasurer say that he was still contemplating doing a fourth budget, so we may see another one. But I think this budget is going to be setting them up for that election. It'd be interesting to see, because we've already seen a number of major announcements in this budget. We've already seen announcements around education. We've already seen announcements around TAFE and giving people placement payments while they're, you know, they're doing their courses. We've seen stuff around housing. We've seen, you know, we've seen spending around domestic violence. So there's been a lot of spending. I think what the economists in particular will be looking for at this budget is to see where the savings are coming from. Because, you know, if it's all about spend, which is kind of how you almost expect pre-election budgets to be, without those savings, then we might find that those predictions in relation to inflation are at risk. So I think the economists in particular will be looking for where are the savings coming from. The consumers out there, the people out there, the voters out there will be seeing what is this budget going to do for their back pocket. Is it actually going to help them with those cost of living you know, crisis that they're facing? And there has been suggestions from both the Prime Minister and Mr. Chalmers that there will be more cost of living relief in this budget. So I'd be keeping a close eye on the spend, but as I said, the economists will be having a close eye on the save.
And this goes to the dilemma here. So for politicians, it's going against every grain of their being to not dish out money when people are struggling and ahead of an election. They want to show that they're listening and they want to help, but you've got this inflationary environment which makes it counterproductive.
Yeah, which is why I think the government and, you know, people like the Katie Gallagher, the finance minister, have been emphasising in the pre-budget discussions about the fact that they're managing to save money. So if they can save money in part, they will also be talking about how they can afford to make this expenditure so that it doesn't add to inflation. So it'll be an interesting balancing. We've said this for the last couple of weeks. It's always a difficult thing for a treasurer to keep everybody happy. Doesn't usually work. But, I mean, it's interesting that he's already been talking about how they're going to help industry. Now, the really interesting part that I haven't really heard at this stage is what they're going to do about small business. Now, that's not often seen as being part of the Labor Party electorate, you know, appeal, but I think they must need to do something about small business, because I know absolutely that the coalition will certainly have a small business policy before the next election, which will be talking about relief for small business and how we can make it easier for small businesses in this country, which employs so many people, how we can make it easier for them to operate.
Indeed, it's a good point. Just finally, I want to ask you before we wrap up, Peter Malinauskas has announced a ban on social media for those under the age of 14. I thought this is a fantastic idea. I think other leaders, state leaders, it'd be smart if they follow suit, because I think there are a lot of parents like me who would be all on board with this idea. Makes it easier when people in their own homes are trying to make the argument to their own kids. Look at the premiers, they're banning it. I think it's a good initiative.
Yes, I think that will be... I think that will be every parent's out, because, you know, it's very difficult to get kids off social media. But if we're saying that it's not going to be allowed by the government and there's a big stick, then that will certainly make it easier. Yeah. The problem will be how you're going to enforce it. I mean, the problem will be that kids kids will still have mobile phones.
But the question is, how do you enforce it in your own house?
Kieran, because I think
all power to Malinauskas. We should see more of it.
Well, I'll be interested to see if other premiers follow suit, because the problem with having big threats and big sticks is if you can't actually use them, then the kids are pretty smart, Kieran. They're going to work out pretty quickly that this is all talk and no real action. So, and you know, we want kids to have mobile phones for a whole lot of reasons. Young kids have phones because it's a security thing. If you're, you know, walking home from school, you want to be able to ring your parents if you're feeling unsafe. You know, all those... No internet access. Is that what you're suggesting?
Exactly. That's
Could
right.
Could be a whole new market for kids' phones.
I think so. I think it might be. Appreciate it. We'll talk to you next week.
Okay. Talk to you soon.